I'm out that Bed-Stuy, home of that boy Biggie. Now I live on Billboard, and I brought my boys with me. Say what up to Tata, still sipping my top. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. Nigga, I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely leave from.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy Elisha here, and welcome back to Go. This is the show where we discuss everything in the world of football from the past week. Now, this is not any breaking news sort of state of emergency type of show. Okay, I know it's Friday. It usually doesn't happen. The show comes out on Monday, but this week, I thought that since the Champions League was this weekend, you know, there's going to be sort of a gap between the Champions League and the regular leagues or whatever. I didn't want to wait until all the way till Monday. So this is kind of a trial. Let's see what happens. Let's see how you guys like it. Let me know in the comments how you feel about this Friday show. And then maybe, just maybe, we'll keep it going during the next weeks when the second leagues at the Copa del Rey, FA Cup, different things like that. Or we could have a special breaking news show in the middle of the week. Something like that, you know, something different. So it's not just one episode per week. But let me know if you would like that or if you just prefer the OR format. Anyways, we're going to be talking about everything this week in the world of football. So let's get right to the business. So first and foremost, we are talking the FA Cup and specifically Manchester United against Chelsea, which ended in 2-0. Andre Herrera and Paul Pogba, two headers for Manchester United, beating Chelsea and knocking them out of the FA Cup. So now in the FA Cup quarterfinals, we're going to have Watford against Crystal Palace, Swansea against Man City, Wolves against Manchester United, and Millwall against Brighton. Now, the game between Chelsea and Manchester City, it seems like Chelsea are in some hot water right now, and Sarri does not care. Let me tell you, this man is in the press conferences like chilling. Like, he hears the fans cursing him out in the stands, and he knows the situation with the team, and he just does not care. Like, this is light. Man is just like, you don't want to see my socks. But this man is just, he's chilling and he does not care. I mean, I feel like, okay, he does care, but he just has a naturally nonchalant personality. So he's not really going to show like, yo, this is not a big deal. Like, I might be getting fired, I might not be, but it's kind of like, yo, we just riding this ways and see what happens. But right now, Chelsea are not doing too good. And if he does get fired before the season ends, who's going to come in and replace him? I doubt that Wenger would do it, to be honest. Like, it just came to my mind as soon as I said replacement. But I was like, nah, after 20-something years with Arsenal, coming back right after that, coming back into football, especially in the Premier League, I don't think he would do it. I really don't think so. But I'm not seeing right now who would actually take on this job. But there's definitely someone who would just step up to the plate. Maybe Thierry Henry could get second shot at coaching. Maybe Monaco didn't work out too much and this might be his chance. Or, which is more probable, Lampard might just say, fuck it, like, just let's come to Chelsea. Forget current team he's coaching right now. Chelsea that's his baby. Let's go. Let me take on this challenge. So it might happen. But at this point right now, Chelsea is just whack right now. Like, they're not, you can't water it down. They're not playing well at all. And United, to be honest though, like, they're not playing well, but they had some chances. I mean, David Luiz got that free kick, you feel me? And you bing, and then, you know, the keeper boom and saved it, and then it bounced back, and Pedro was like, Pedro, boom, and then hit it back, and then it bounced again. It was a double save. There was some other opportunities where bing, it went in, and but then it didn't, because it was a lot of stuff going on, right? But overall, they had a bad game. United had a better game than them, but let's move on to the Champions League anyways. Those are the big boy games. The big, big boy games. And the first day ended with no goals. No goals! Barca, Lyon, 0-0. Very underwhelming considering, and let me say this, Lyon is an attacking team. An attacking team, and they were attacking. Sometimes, it was mostly counterattack because they were, you know how Barca plays. When you play against Barca, you got to be careful. Like, on a bad day, Barca will whoop your booty. They will violate. Okay, so you can't be letting up on defense. That's why teams like Atletico give Barca so much problems, because defensively they're so solid. They don't give them any space. So Leon did their thing on defense, but neither, like, apparently so did Barca, because neither team were able to score. And it was the same thing for Bayern Liverpool. Even though Sané got a golden opportunity to score, Liverpool were really putting on the pressure. I think they were the better team out of the two, definitely in that game. But neither of them could actually, four teams, two games going on at the same damn time and no goals. I don't like that. I like good football, you feel me? It's like, yes, you're attacking or whatever, and I'm liking the plays, but at the end of the day, I want to see some goals. Like, I want to see some goals. And then, you feel me? Schalke, Man City didn't disappoint. Even though Schalke got two penalty goals, but two very nice penalties at that, and Man City came back from a 2-1 deficit. They were 1-0. Aguero scored the first goal. Schalke came on two back-to-back free kicks before the second half, and then Man City came back and won it. Sané with a beautiful free kick. I'm pretty sure I said Sané before for Liverpool, but I meant Mane, but you probably got that. But Sané, beautiful free kick from Man City, and then Sterling so effortlessly. Yo, when I tell you, Sterling's goal looks like, it's like a first touch control, not a shot. Like, you know when you're on a momentum and the keeper, it is like you're, everybody is behind. It's like a counterattack after a corner or something. Like, I know you're picturing what I'm trying to visualize for you guys right now. It's a corner, you got a counterattack, and somehow the ball goes and it's just one player. Everybody else is behind, one man with the goalkeeper counterattack, and the keeper is approaching, and you got to make that long touch, right, to kind of send the keeper away and then go in and just slide it in the goal. Pause. But that's exactly how his goal looked. It didn't look like it was a shot. It was so effortless. It was great. It was just great. On the other side of that, Juventus versus Atletico, that was the powerhouse game of this week. That's what, like, people were expecting, you know? Ronaldo's first game back in Madrid, you know, and it's his old rivals, Atletico. We have such a strong offensive team in Juventus. They have a lot to prove right now. They're trying to get back into the final after a couple years. And now they have Ronaldo, the guy who's won 5 Champions League, and he did not miss the opportunity to let the people know. I don't know if the bench or the fans were just yapping and saying a whole bunch of things, but at some point he was like, y'all gotta, hey, don't you forget it. Don't you forget it. Five of them. Don't you forget it. And y'all have none. And after the game also, walking past all the reporters, he said it. I have 5 Champions League. Atleti have none. And you know what? You can say that it's cocky. You can say that, yeah, you know, he's kind of an asshole for it or whatever. But, you know, it's, you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's true. It's true. You can't hate. You can't hate on it. He has 5. 4 with Madrid, 1 with Manchester United. He has 5. What can you say? He's allowed to say. If y'all talking smack, he's going to remind y'all that you have none and that he beat you twice in the finals. He stole, just sniped 2 Champions League from y'all. So put some respect on my man's name. Put some respect on it, because he will remind you every single time. Even though he doesn't have it with Juventus, he probably won't. Like, I can't see Atletico blowing this. With the type of defense that they have, Juventus are screwed. Like, they're not making it. I already know Atletico is going to move on to the next round. Like, their defense is too strong, and they have that 2-goal advantage now. They're going to run away with this one. But 2-0, beautiful goals, very exciting game. Atletico's defense, like I've said before, so organized. And after the first game, Simeone just grabbing a handful of his cojones. Like, this man is hilarious. Like, the passion, the intensity that this man has from when he was playing to now coaching is incredible. Like, that's what it's all about. Like, you don't care, bro. I don't care that there's, like, cameras and sponsorships and all of that. Like, I'm gonna grab a handful and show y'all, yo, we got balls. Like, we're ready to play and we dominating y'all. That's just what it was. And our home crowd too, and the fans loved it. Of course, the media has to kind of twist it or whatever a little bit after that. But he did apologize, saying that, you know, it's in the heat of a moment. It's just, it's that's what football's about. It's the heart, it's the love. It just makes you do stuff without thinking. It's beautiful. But yeah, man, that was basically it for Champions League. And we gotta wait a couple more weeks, 3-4 weeks more until the next time. But I'm excited for how those second legs are gonna come through. I definitely know that there are gonna be some upsets. Hopefully not for my mains right here, not for the boys, but you know, I don't know. I feel like there's gonna be some upsets. You can definitely look forward to that. I'm thinking Barca is gonna get the best of Lyon in the next match, and they're gonna move on, especially since they're gonna be at the Camp Nou. So that's a big advantage for them. And I definitely think that Liverpool is gonna go through on Bayern, and it's not like they're gonna score. They're definitely gonna be some goals. Like, we're not gonna see none of that nil-nil, none of that 1-0 stuff in those games. We can expect that for Juventus, Atleti. I think Atletico, again, is gonna score. It's gonna be 1-0. They're gonna shut out Juventus completely in the second leg. And I think that Man City also is gonna go through on Schalke. And also, in the Europa League, it seems like Arsenal were finally able to masturbate. To master, as in take control of bait, the team, not that. None of that. But yeah, Arsenal this time around, second leg of this stage of the Europa League, was able to take control of their fate in this competition and go one step further in the quest of winning the Europa League. One own goal. The second goal was by Mustafi, and the third one by Papopoulos. You could Google it. This guy. He's gonna put it right. This guy right here. He scored the third goal, and it was 3-1 on aggregate. Arsenal versus Bate. So Arsenal show that, you know, they make mistakes, but sometimes it's not over until it's over. It was a second lie. People doubted them. People were clowning them, especially me. The Bate jokes are amazing. I love them. I love it. Master Bate. Anyways, that's pretty much it in actual football news. Also, drip. Winnie Harlow. Shout out to the beautiful Winnie Harlow, man. Shout out to all the people in different subcultures of the world repping football, man. Wonderful, illustrious, fabulous, incredible. Winnie Harlow was walking in the Biblos show this week in Milan Fashion Week, and she was wearing the shirt, the Inter shirt, celebrating their 20-year partnership with Nike. So it had some bits and pieces from all the Inter Milan shirts from over that 20-year period. So it had like the Mancini era and the Mourinho, all of these different shirts, just like Barca did in their shirt that incorporated different ones from over the years, but it's dope. I'm gonna put it right here so you guys can see it. It's a dope shirt, and it's a nice way to commemorate 2 decades of just great football. You know, Inter hasn't been their best, I have to admit, in the last few years, but you know, I sense a comeback coming. I definitely do. And I hope that all the drama with Icardi and him getting dropped as the captain, all that can be resolved, and they can bring in some new powerhouse players to bring them back to the golden age of Milan. AC Milan too. I wish all of these teams the best, man. I just want to see great football. That's it. I just want to see beautiful football. That's what we do here at Go. We embody greatness in football. Greatness in football. But that's pretty much gonna be it for this week in football, guys. I'm gonna see you guys right back here again on Monday. Oh yeah, because there's more games this weekend. What kind of accent was that? What are you doing? Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you drop a like for it. Also subscribe to the channel right down there. Oh, don't die. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell also so you don't miss any of the videos when they drop. So you don't gotta be looking in the search bar for Gaul when a video drops, okay? You get a notification so you know exactly when we drop some heat, all right? Also, make sure you check out the music and the social media to Gaul in the description. I'll see you guys next time, actually in 3 days. Peace. Outside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. Nigga, I be spiked out. I could trip a referee.